Hello everyone, today we're going to look at a backup solution called Duplicati. Duplicati is an application that enables you to create an offsite backup, meaning a backup that is not located on your local Raspberry, but offsite, and in my case, and that's also what we're going to test later on, is a backup towards the cloud, towards OneDrive. Why do you need this? Well, if your domotics environment becomes more and more important, and you're also, for instance, testing with the latest beta releases, then it could happen that your domotics environment crashes, or worst case scenario, if your complete memory card crashes, that you're always able to restore your complete environment. So what we're going to do, we're going to install a number of prerequisites that are required for Duplicati in order to run. First, we're going to install the Mono framework, which is basically the .NET framework for Linux. Then we're going to sync certificates, installing the Duplicati application, setting up a Duplicati service that enables us to run Duplicati automatically after each time that you reboot the system. And then we're going to look at the web GUI, the web interface from Duplicati, and setting up our first backup and trying to restore a file. So the first step is that we're going to install the Mono framework for .NET support by using the command sudo apt-get install mono-complete ca dash certificates dash mono dash y. Okay, enter. It's going to install quite a lot of files here. Don't be worried, it takes about 5 minutes. So I will do a fast forward in my video that you don't have to wait. Okay, so the Mono framework has been installed. Let's first clean our screen. So now we're going to install the Duplicati application. The Duplicati application comes from GitHub, which is actually quite a long command to manually fill out. So I'll just copy it in and I will see if I can put it into the comments field from the YouTube video, that you can just copy paste the command. So wget, then I'm going to paste, press enter. So once the Duplicati application has been retrieved from GitHub as now, then we need to install it by using the command sudo apt-get install .slash duplicati underscore 2.0.4.23-1 underscore all .dev minus y. I made a small typo. Duplicati. So now it's installing Duplicati. And once this is finished, we're gonna set up the Duplicati to run it as a service, so that after every reboot, it's able to start immediately. Okay, so Duplicati has now been installed. So now we will set up the actual service file. You can do that by running the command sudo nano, so that's the simple editor, slash etc slash system d slash system slash duplicati dot service. enter. Then I'm just gonna paste the information in that I actually need. And I'm gonna press Control X to save the file we just created and press yes. Enter. Also here I will put the information I just filled out in the Nano. So also here I will put it into the comments fields, the information I just put into the service file that you can just copy paste the information in. So now we need to create a init script file by using the following commands: sudo So now we're going to create the init script file, so the file that is required to stop and start the service. And we're going to do that by using the command sudo . So now we are going to configure the init script file, so the file that is required to stop and start the actual service, which we just created. So we need to fill out the command sudo nano slash etc slash default slash duplicati. So what we need to change is the last sentence. Just gonna remove the whole sentence, paste in the correct information. Okay, so you need to fill it out like this. So daemon opts web service interface is any. So in the actual file, you need to change the last sentence. Just gonna paste it in. And then if you put in the information, press Control X and save it by pressing Y and then enter to go back to the prompt. So now we have the actual service created. We have the init script created. So the only thing we now need to do is enable the Duplicati service by running the command sudo systemctl enable duplicati.service. So now it created a link that after every reboot it will start the service. Now let's reload the daemon /reload. And now we're going to start the Duplicati service. I'm going to back with one command. And we're going to say start Duplicati.service. So what did we just do? First, we enabled the Duplicati service, making sure that after every reboot, it's starting. Second, we made sure that the service daemon was being reloaded. So that also means the Duplicati service is included. And now, with the last command, we manually started the Duplicati service. Now, you can validate if the service is actually running. I'm going one command back by using the command status and then duplicati.service. Now, here you can see that everything is running accordingly. So that's good. So we're going to look at the web browser to see if the web GUI is actually functioning. If yes, then we can start creating our backup. Now, before we go to Duplicati to create our first backup job, it's important to first go to Domotics and go to Setup and Settings. And if you go down, then you will see there's an option called Automatic Backup, which is default off, and you're able to enable. Why do you need this option? Well, it's important with databases that you don't have any open transactions when a backup is being created. So therefore, if you use the automatic backup solution from Domotics, you will get a daily, hourly, and weekly database backup, which is created into the backups folder inside your Domotics folder, and that will enable you to restore a database without any transactional errors. So it's very important that you enable this option. And if you do an actual restore of your database, it's wise to do the restore from this folder that Domotics is creating called backups. Now, next up, we go to Duplicati, and Duplicati is accessible on port 8200. It has its own web GUI. So in your browser, use the IP address of your Raspberry Pi followed by the port number 8200-8200. Well, it's actually pretty straightforward. So we have an add backup function. We have a restore function and settings. If there's a new version of Duplicati, then you will receive a pop-up that you can update the application. It's pretty straightforward. And if you go to settings, what can I mention here? Well, you can remove the donation messages and also the usage statistics. If you don't want to share it with someone, then put it on disabled. I've got one backup job created. Just see if we can, yeah. So if you would create a new backup, which I'm not doing right now, I'm just editing the one I currently have, then you will see the same setup as we have right here. So the first step is that you need to create your backup job a name. Encryption is default on 256. You can say generate a passphrase, wise to actually do. Then you press next. Then you go into the step two. Step two has the destination path, so where do you want to backup towards, which path. Well, I'm using Microsoft OneDrive into a certain folder. And if you use Microsoft OneDrive, you need to have an API code so that OneDrive also accepts the requests coming from Duplicati. And to create the API code, you need to press Authenticate ID. And then it will open up OneDrive requesting you to fill in your details. And then it will create this code that you can just copy paste into this particular field. Then step three is your source data. So you can just, in the tree structure, drill down to the certain folders which you would like to backup. And if you want, you can apply filters or exclude certain files. Then the schedule. Well, I'm also always running my backup at 3 o'clock every day. Then options. The remote volume size is 50 MB. Well, it's advisable to leave it as standard. And the backup retention, I'm using the option smart backup retention, which actually means that you have a grandfather, father, son setup. That means you have a daily, weekly, monthly, and year backup stored. So it's actually quite a good setup, which a lot of IT companies are also using. What else? So once you've created your backup job, you will see the backup jobs available under home. Well, as you can see right now, you can also run it immediately. So for instance, if you would do if you would update your Domotics with a new release, then it's of course also advisable to just create a backup. So you can just say run now before you start updating your software. Then in case you need to do a restore, you go to the restore function. Then we're going to restore from the backup job. So in this case, Domotics. Then we say next. Then it's going to fetch the information. And here you can actually see the dates in time. So again, so daily, weekly, monthly. Well, let's just select the date. Then it's going to look at the available folders and files that you're able to restore. So, and then it's a matter of ticking the boxes if you want to restore a complete folder or if you want to restore a certain file, also possible. And with the restore options, you can choose the original location or a specific folder, which I normally do. I never restore to the original location. I always put it somewhere else in a different folder structure. For me, seems to be a little bit more safer than just start overwriting files. Permissions, advisable to restore the read and write permissions. Else it's possible, for instance, I run everything under the user PI. That it starts restoring on the root, and all your files are now have the permissions on root instead of PI, and that's giving you some issues. And then it's a matter of pressing the option restore, and it's restoring your files. And the web interface will also give you a message when the actual restore has been performed. And I must say, so far I'm actually quite happy with this piece of software. Just to give you some examples where I had some issues in the past. I had issues with moving over to a new beta version where I needed to restore a last application file from Domotics. I had issues with Node-RED, that I was sending information from Node-RED to Domotics, and all of a sudden my database corrupted. Well, if I had this 1 year ago, then I was in some big issues, didn't know how to recover. But now, if it actually happens, it's pretty straightforward. Just restore the database, or in case of a update that fails from Domotics, then simply restore the model's executable, that you can go back in time, and yeah, you're up and running again. So it nowadays it's pretty low risk to experiment with the modX, with new updates, or with some experiments with third-party tools. If something fails, then you have the ability to restore. So I hope this helps you to create an offsite backup to make your environment more secure, and especially if the modX becomes more and more important. Well, actually, in my case, it has. Then you have the option to perform a restore. So thank you for watching, and I'll soon create a new video again. Thank you. Bye-bye.